Ahoy, ye mateys! GameRanks presents the 7 best pirate games. I'm not gonna do that. Sorry, I apologize. The Golden Age of Pirates was a real thing and inspired many a story, song, and film, and video games are no exception, so let's get right into it. Number 7. Risen 2, Dark Waters. Even though the original Risen was a medieval fantasy game, Risen 2 is a swashbuckling-themed game that takes Caribbean pirate themes into a fantasy world where there's ancient gods and voodoo magic and stuff like that. It's a pretty awesome RPG that players can explore this cool Caribbean pirate world. And many people really enjoyed it much more than the original Risen. Number 6, Galleon. Now, Galleon was kind of a pirate game. It kind of had a Monkey Island vibe and was very inspired by the voyages of Sinbad. And you play as Rama, who was a pirate swashbuckling adventure type guy. It was very hokey, but you explore and you jump off cliffs and find treasure and explore pirate islands, and it was a really cool game and very underrated, and it was kind of a spiritual successor to the original Tomb Raider, so it's definitely worth checking out if you're really into pirate games. Number 5, Age of Booty. Age of Booty was a real-time multiplayer strategy game that allowed players to helm their own ship and sink enemy opponents, and it was a blast, no pun intended. When you played, you would team up with online players or with AI and explore and pillage and do pirate things, and it was really cool and had excellent pirate music and a lot of ARGs. And it's called Age of Booty. Number 4, Kingdoms of Amalur: Reckoning, The Legend of Dead Kell DLC. Now, The Legend of Dead Kell is an expansion pack for that ill-fated, but nevertheless pretty awesome, Kingdoms of Amalur RPG. It added a pretty decent-sized chunk of content to the main game with a new island called Gallows End, which was basically a pirate zombie island. You could even have your own little pirate mansion with a new player housing called Gravehall Keep. So while Kingdoms of Amalur definitely isn't really a pirate game, this pirate island-themed DLC was really authentic and just really captured that fun, awesome pirate vibe. Number 3, the Monkey Island series. Now, everybody knows the Monkey Island series, the point-and-click adventure game made by LucasArts is an incredible classic that many of us have never forgotten. You played as the hero Guybrush Threepwood, the mighty pirate, and you took on the most dangerous pirate in the Caribbean, you defeat the plans of evil undead pirate LeChuck, and even win the heart of Elaine Marley. The humor, the vibe, the tone, the settings, everything in Monkey Island really made a perfect pirate game. And it was definitely an unforgettable adventure with awesomely lovable pirate characters. Number 2, Sid Meier's Pirates. This is another one that many of you probably definitely know. Sid Meier's Pirates was a game that pretty much had every aspect of pirate life nailed down. There was real-time sea battles, turn-based land battles, dancing, tactical sword fighting that was pretty cool. It's pretty much the full pirate package. The classic version was developed in 1987, and then they had the remake in 2004, which most people played. It's also now available for iOS, and it's a pretty good version of it. I'd say some of the stuff hasn't held up well over time, but it's still definitely a classic that is worth checking out. Number 1, Assassin's Creed 4, Black Flag. Now, if you guys know me, you know Assassin's Creed 4 is one of my favorite games, and definitely my favorite Assassin's Creed game. Talk about the full pirate package I was talking about with pirates. Assassin's Creed 4 nails it even better. You start out as Edward Kenway, who's pretty much a drunk asshole who stumbles into the role of a pirate and eventually finds himself with a ship, and then you take him on the high seas and explore and pillage and fight other ships and travel to mysterious islands, hunt for treasure. You do a thousand things in this game that I can't even name it all. You even meet up with Blackbeard, who was a real actual pirate. This game is no joke, and especially because you can hunt whales and stuff. Everything about it just feels so meticulously created and full of pirate detail, down to the shanties that your pirate crew sings as you sail the high seas. You guys probably know, if you play the game, you definitely have all these shanties stuck in your head. What will we do with a drunken sailor? What will we, you know what I mean. So those were the 7 best pirate games, the best representation of adventures on the high seas. There's not really a lot of pirate games out there, but if I did miss any, let us know in the comments what your favorite pirate game is. I know there's an MMO, Pirates of the Burning Sea, that I don't know too much about, but let me know any pirate games that you guys enjoy, and definitely subscribe if you haven't, because we do lists like this all the time. I'm serious. So hopefully we see you out on the high seas, and we'll see you next time. Yarr! Okay, yeah, no, not doing it.